All right, let's check in with literally the newest member of the UFC roster. He steps in on short notice this Saturday to take on Daniel Rodriguez in Las Vegas. Welcome to the UFC, Gabriel Green. How are you, sir?
Man, I'm doing great. I'm just happy to be here. Thank you for having me.
Absolutely. Have you allowed yourself to take in those words at all, welcome to the UFC, or has it just been so chaotic getting everything ready for Saturday, you haven't had time to really let it settle in yet?
I think it's going to settle in after I get that dub. it's everything's moving pretty fast. And they got me moving around. I had a bunch of medicals to get done. Got all those done yesterday. I was moving around a lot because it's super last minute. They kept me up before 4 a.m. My coach called me. He's like, we're going. So then we all jumped in a car, drove straight to Vegas and had a bunch of work to do.
So we found out Tuesday morning that Kevin Holland was out of the fight, suffered an injury while in training. And then hours later, we found out that you were in. Can you sort of walk us through what Tuesday was like for you and how you even entered this equation?
Yeah, I mean, my coach hit me up Monday night and was like, how's your weight? And I was like, I mean, it's good. I can make weight like any time. So what's up? And then he was like, just be ready. There might be something really soon. And I was like, all right, I'm ready. Just let me know. And then basically Tuesday morning, it turned out to be a lot sooner than we all thought. We got the call. So we just all jumped in the truck and just bounced over here to Vegas.
So for those who are hearing your voice for the first time, you have won your last 6 fights. You're 9-2 as a pro. You fought for the likes of Bellator, Combate Americas. And I think you've been to one decision in your entire career, and that was in your amateur debut. I'm curious, since this is the first time we've been talking, how did you find this crazy sport, if you don't mind me asking?
I mean, I grew up, I was always a fan of fighting. I didn't actually formally train until I was in college and had like a job to pay for it. Cause my fam wasn't a big fan of it, of me trying to, what they say, bash my brains in. But, as soon as I was able to afford, the gym membership and the classes myself, I jumped into it. And then just, it's been going ever since.
Throughout your career, you have been incredibly active. All 11 of your pro fights have happened since April of 2016, but this is going to be your first fight in almost 2 years. I know you're supposed to fight for Bellator in January, but what led to such a long layoff for you and having to miss all of 2019?
So in the last fight that I competed in, I broke my hand, winning that championship belt. So I had to go to the doctors and get x-rays and all that stuff. And while I was in there, my shoulder had been bugging me for a very long time. And I was like, I'm one of those people who don't go to the doctor so much. So I was in there. I was like, you know what? You mind checking out the shoulder, making sure it's all right. And then they did some tests and it turns out it was a lot more messed up than I could even imagine. So I had to get a shoulder surgery. So I was on a wait list for that for a long time. And then once I got that shoulder surgery, I had to do a bunch of rehab and make sure it was all good to go. And then, as soon as I was good to go and I got the green light to start training and practicing again and competing again, I had to pull out of that January fight because of another injury mishap during practice. So that sucked. But as soon as my rib was good, I wanted to get back into everything and go again. Because, I mean, like you mentioned, I was fighting all the time. I really love fighting more than anything. Like, greatest thing I've ever done. So I just like, going out there and putting on a show for people. And I want to do it all the time. But yeah, unfortunately, I had to take some breaks from it. And I was trying to jump back into it. And then Corona happened. And then I had to take another little pause from it. But then now I got this opportunity because of Corona, probably, like, most likely, and just kind of happy that Corona happened, I guess.
How long do you think you were fighting with that shoulder injury?
Honestly, it was probably, I used to play football, in high school and, I messed up both of my shoulders pretty bad. And, I'm pretty sure it's just from that. And I just like my entire fight career, I was fighting with it, but I could like, I saw the progression of my left shoulder, just like every like month of training, just like, it just felt a little more off until like at the end when I was, going to do fights, I was really like just not even using my left arm in practices. We were saving it for fights, like just trying to keep it as good as possible for the actual competition.
So you see, like in baseball, you see pitchers out for a year, 18 months, and they get like Tommy John surgery and they think it's like the worst thing in the world. And then when they come back, they feel and they perform better than ever. Do you feel better than you've ever felt in your career now that you've had your shoulder all fixed up and gotten through those injuries?
It's dramatic. I have more pop in my left shoulder than I've ever had, like since I've started fighting. It's ridiculous. It's like, I actually have two arms now. Gonna be awesome.
I know you were healing up and everything, and that was the thing at the top of the list that you needed to take care of, but has it been sort of bizarre and strange mentally for you to go so long without a fight? I think this is the longest layoff you've had. I think the longest layoff you've had in your career is like 4 or 5 months or something like that.
Yeah, no, this was super bizarre. Like it's, I honestly like love fighting. It's, and then like, you know, I'm still around the gym when I'm injured and it seems like, imagine like, you know, you was with a girl and then you guys had like you guys decided to take a break, but you still see her around town all the time. And you're just like, ah, like I remember when I used to do that, or, you know, that's basically what it felt like. So it's just like a longing to be back. I'm so happy that I have this opportunity to fight again more than anything. I mean, it's super dope that it's with the UFC, like that, take that all day. It's, you know, the top of the top right now. So that's where I want to be. But yeah, I'm just happy to fight in general.
You mentioned your family wasn't overly thrilled with you getting into fighting and, you know, like you said, having your head busted. How have they reacted to the news that all this work, all this time you put into something that maybe they weren't too sure about early on, you've reached sort of the pinnacle in fight sports in terms of making the promotion that is the number one in the world. How have they reacted to it?
They're super excited. Like when I got that phone call, that's a little, my parents, when I walked into the room, I woke them up. I was like, I'm going to the UFC. And they were just like, they were wilding out just like me. It was pretty awesome. They weren't a really big fan of it at the beginning, but then, you know, they saw me go through my amateur career and I was doing really good, and they saw me go pro and I was doing really good. And they just like, you know what? They're like, they really wanted me to be a doctor. So they're just like, I mean, you're not a doctor, but at least you're doing what you love and you're good at it. So they're, you know, they're proud of me and they backed me up 100%.
That's awesome. How relieving was that for you, knowing that you had their blessing after all this time?
We grew up in a family that's super tight knit, really family oriented. So to have my family backing me up, it's pretty amazing. It is a little weird that they're not here with me though, because usually they're, you know, I'm a pretty good ticket seller and I have usually a whole bunch of people that are going to be, you know, at the fight cheering me on and stuff like that. So not having them there is going to be a little weird, but I think I'm going to do all right still.
You're going to fight Daniel Rodriguez and it's super short notice. So the opponent almost doesn't even matter at this point, I assume. But, you know, what are these next couple of days going to be like for you in terms of preparing for Daniel? Will you even have time to prepare for the fighter himself?
I mean, like we checked out some videos. We saw what he does. I was actually supposed to fight him back in 2018. I scheduled to fight him after I won that belt, but I broke my hand in the fight. And then it turned out my shoulder was a lot more messed up than I thought it was. So I had to pull out of that one. So we had already kind of looked at him a while back. I mean, he's progressed as a fighter a little bit, but, you know, still just happy to have the opportunity to fight in the first place. So we take anyone on at this point. It's cool that it's Daniel because we already, you know, are a little more familiar with him than anything. Almost kind of perfect. So, but more than anything, we're just making sure that I'm sharp instead of worrying about the opponent exactly.
You mentioned sort of the chaotic part of all this, you know, coming back from the injuries and being in the middle of a global pandemic. But from like a preparation standpoint, is it nice to just sort of just get right into this thing, like get in the truck, go to Vegas, medical test, hit the scale, go fight? You know what I mean?
Yeah, I mean, there is some kind of perks to it. It does feel kind of nice. There's like, you know, I'm someone who works out a lot in general. And I think I go into fights almost overtrained sometimes. So, you know, like the fact that a pandemic was going on. So I'm, you know, I'm training a little less than I normally do just because I don't have access to a whole bunch of stuff. So I think by like default, it's almost impossible for me to be overtrained for this fight, which is a good thing, you know. And then it definitely feels good, you know, like just to go out there and not really have to, you know, worry about anything, you know, mentally going to anything. It's just like, all right, we're going to go fight. I love to fight. So I'm just like, all right, cool. Let's skip all the other stuff and let's just get straight to fight week.
Do you feel like you're essentially playing with house money right now, that there's very little pressure on you?
Yeah. I mean, like I said, I'm just happy to be here more than anything. I just want to fight.
How about the empty arena stuff? Are you looking forward to competing there? How's that going to feel? Have you had a chance to sort of visualize what that might look like?
You know what? From what I've seen on the other fights that happened, you know, the previous weekends, I kind of like that there's no crowd. I like how it sounds and it looks like on television. I like that it's real quiet, because that's more like what the gym is in anyways, you know, like we're in there just like a small amount of people just doing our thing. So I feel like that's actually a good thing.
So how do you get this done on Saturday? What can fans expect from gifted Gabriel Green when you step into the octagon for the first time this weekend?
Expect fireworks. You know, I go out there, I do my thing. I only been the distance one time, and it was the worst feeling of my life standing there with my hand down, you know, waiting to see if it was going to get raised or not. It's a lot better feeling when you know, like, your hand's going to get raised. So after that, I was like, you know, forget this. I'm going to get my hand raised every time. Or I'm going to know my hand's going to be raised every time. I ain't going to no decision. Judges can kind of just, you know, take a break, take a water break, bathroom break, whatever. Because it definitely ain't going the distance. I don't know if it's going to be a knockout. I don't know if it's going to be a sub. I just know it's not going all the way.
Gabe, I appreciate the time very much. I know you have a fight in a couple of days, and it means a lot that you'd squeeze me in for a few minutes. Congratulations on the call. Anything else you want to get off your chest before I let you go?
Nah, man. You know, I just wanted to thank you. Thank you for taking the time to talk to me. And thank everybody who's, you know, backed me on this journey so far. Appreciate all you guys.